Hare Krishna. Humility frees us from dependence on our own power and grants us access to God's power. Some people feel that to be humble is to become weak. Actually, humility makes us strong, not weak. How? Because let's consider the opposite of humility. When we have pride or arrogance, then what happens? We think that we are very strong. We think that we are very powerful. We think that whatever we want to do, we can do ourselves. And yes, we may have some power, but our power is limited. And even if our power is comparatively speaking greater than the power of those around us, still our power is no match to the far greater power of the forces which are bigger than us, of nature, of time, and ultimately of God. So nature and time are pushing and crushing us at each moment, and we will be thwarted by them. As long as we lack humility, we are dependent on our own power. And sometimes even our desires, our cravings, our addictions can become far stronger than us, and they prevent us from accessing God, from accessing any power higher than ours. So knowledge means to understand this reality of our position in the overall scheme of things, and to understand God's supreme position. And when we have such knowledge, then we use our power, whatever we have, to access God's far greater power. And thus, the Bhagavad Gita, which describes the 20 characteristics of knowledge in the 13th chapter, 13:8-12, describes at the first characteristic of knowledge, the doorway to entering into the world of knowledge is humility. Amanittvam adambhittvam ahimsa shantirarjavam acharyopasanam shaucham sthairyam atmavinigraha. So Krishna says amanittvam. And then later on he says, maicha ananya yogena bhaktir avyabhicharini, that we can practice unflinching, undistracted devotion to Krishna when we are situated in knowledge. And we enter into that knowledge by humility. So when we recognize the finiteness of our power and understand that the purpose of our power is to access Krishna's power, to make our purpose to fulfilling His purpose, to use our will to do His will, then what happens is we get access to His supreme power. That's why when we are overpowered by situations, when we are being overpowered by temptations, instead of simply trying to resist those situations or temptations ourselves, if we are humble enough to seek the shelter of Krishna, then we will find that Krishna will empower us and we will be able to transcend those situations and transcend those temptations. And then we will realize that humility is not weakening, but is empowering. In fact, it is supremely empowering. Not that it makes us supreme, but it gives us greater empowerment than anything else ever can. Thank you. Hare Krishna.